Hey everyone, and welcome back to our channel. We're extremely grateful for all the support you've shown on our past videos. We've just reached 50 subscribers, and that's a huge milestone for us, so thank you for that. This week we'll be covering the first graph you learn about in economics, and that's the production possibilities curve. By the end of this video, you'll not only know what it is, but how it shows other key economic concepts such as scarcity, trade-offs, and increasing marginal opportunity costs. The production possibilities curve, sometimes referred to as the production possibilities frontier, is a fundamental graph in introductory economics. It shows the range of possible output combinations in an economy. The basic production possibilities model is based on three assumptions. One, an economy only makes two products. Two, resources and technology are fixed in this economy. And three, all resources or factors of production are to be employed to their fullest capacity. Now I know that some of these assumptions are rather strong, but hey, we're economists and outlandish assumptions to help with our model is just what we do. So bear with me here. So now we have two goods, let's say guitars and pianos. And let's assume that they require the same inputs, time, wood, metal, etc., to make. Now suppose in a single day, one instrument manufacturing firm can make the following combinations of guitars and pianos. If the firm only makes guitars, it can produce 50, but therefore it does not have the resources to make any pianos. Alternatively, the firm can produce 45 guitars and 2 pianos, or 30 guitars and 3 pianos. Finally, if the firm uses all of its resources to make pianos, it can create 4 pianos, but therefore no guitars. So notice that there is a trade-off happening. Either you have to give up guitars to get more pianos, or you have to give up pianos to get more guitars. Now let's graph this table and see what it looks like. Each point on our table is labeled, and we see that the result is a concave line connecting the two axes. Each axis has one of the two goods on it, so the concave shape represents an increase in how much you have to give up of one good to receive more of the other good. This is actually how opportunity cost ties into the graph. As you can see, to go from point B to point C, I gain one piano, as represented by the difference in the x-axis between points B and C. But what did I give up? I give up 15 guitars, which is the difference on the y-axis between points B and C. So in this case, an economist would say that the opportunity cost of going from point B to point C is 15 guitars. Remember, opportunity cost is just that, a cost. So the unit will always be in terms of what you give up. Now take a look at this production possibilities curve. Notice that point A is on the curve, meaning that we are producing the maximum instruments possible with the resources that we have available. If this is the case, point B is not a possible point to produce at, as to produce at point B, we would need more resources than we currently have in our economy, therefore this point is outside of the PPC. But what about point C? Point C is obtainable, as it does not maximize our resources, but that's the problem. We would never choose to produce at point C, because we're not using all of the available resources and therefore are missing out on additional guitars or pianos that we could be making. We don't want any leftover resources as we do not receive any utility from them. So to maximize efficiency, we must always be producing a combination which falls on the actual production possibilities curve. So there you go, now you know what the PPC is all about. In the future, we plan to make a video outlining how to draw the PPC yourself, as well as the types of economic shocks which will shift or rotate the PPC. Stay tuned for that video. If you like this video and are excited to see more, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment what sort of economic topics you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.